Good evening, everyone. The city of Clive is poised to give a yellow light to red light cameras.
Emily Price explains this controversial decision. It's new at 10.
Right now, Clive's red light cameras are turned off because of a vote last month to not renew a long-term contract with the camera company. But in a vote tomorrow night, the city appears to be turning the cameras back on temporarily.
For years, the city of Clive has heard the complaints.
They're just making money off every single one.
We've got way too much government involvement in everything. Would you like me to expand on that?
Sure, if you like.
No, you don't have time enough.
I received an overwhelming response from folks that simply don't want them there. They think it's part of intrusive government. They think that a majority of the money is generated through, you know, through illegal activity. And quite frankly, people just don't like, I guess, the Big Brother idea of watching you.
Thursday's proposal would do two things: turn the cameras back on until June 30th, 2014, the end of this fiscal year. It would also do away with the ordinance that allows red light cameras in Clive effective the same date. So why not just keep the cameras turned off? The answer is the $700,000 the city expects to get from them between now and then, which is already budgeted in.
I don't necessarily believe that it has increased safety. I think that it generates a significant amount of revenue, but I think through good financial planning that we can overcome that.
Some council members, like Eric Klein, don't want them back on at all. Others, like Councilman Ted Weaver, sent out this statement saying it's a sufficient compromise to finally end the controversial cameras.
Everything's a little shade of gray.
I spoke with other council members tonight who say they don't want the cameras back on at all, and there are ways, they say, around relying on that $700,000 in revenue, like, for instance, holding off on specific spending.
Well, this would actually kind of be historic in a municipal government sort of way, wouldn't it?
That's right. They say it would be. If this passes, Clive would be the first Iowa town to phase out those controversial cameras.
We'll see what happens. Thanks, Ann.